This is Dr. Lam from drlam.com and the Adrenal Fatigue Center. Today, we're going to talk about what happens to people when they're under stress in terms of their bowels. Some people can have tight bowel movements or constipation, while other people can have loose bowel movements when they're under stressful situation. All this is part of the flight or fight response that the body has. Now, this fight or flight response is built into the system that we have as part of our DNA. It is regulated by the autonomic nervous system. Now, when a person is under stress, the autonomic nervous system usually is under control and try to remove the stress. The adrenal system is primarily the first responder. When this fails, the body goes into an adrenaline response and as a last resort to basically help the body survive. Now, this response is characterized by several hormones, including epinephrine or adrenaline, as well as norepinephrine. In addition to the sympathetic nervous system, which is part of the autonomic nervous response, there's also another branch called the parasympathetic nervous system that is involved as well. The neurotransmitter responsible is what we call acetylcholine in this particular branch. Now, normally the sympathetic system is kept at bay and well balanced by the parasympathetic nervous system. In times of stress, however, these two systems, which normally balances each other, may be out of whack, so to say. If the sympathetic system is too strong and the parasympathetic system is too weak, then one would experience constipation. On the other hand, if the parasympathetic system becomes overwhelming relative to the sympathetic system, then the bowel relaxes and the body can have diarrhea. Such is the case with the irritable bowel syndrome when the body's autonomic responses and the parasympathetic and the sympathetic systems are not well controlled in terms of balancing each other. And one can have bouts of alternating diarrhea or constipation as this case may be. Everybody is different. Some people have predominant constipation, some people have predominant diarrhea. And these are all part of the fight or flight response. So the best thing to do, if you want to avoid such a gastric discomfort and irregularity, is to have a healthy autonomic response. Now, remember that the autonomic response is a last resort fight or flight mechanism that's only activated when the body has overwhelming stress it cannot deal with. So if you trace the problem to the root, reducing stress seems a logical and is in fact one of the best way to rebalance the autonomic nervous system. Now, once the stress is removed, and it has to be removed at the stress, at the root level, and not being symptomatically controlled by medications as well as natural compounds, then the autonomic nervous system will be able to self-regulate. Once the self-regulation process kicks in, then the diarrhea or constipation or muscle spasms, or sweaty palms, or flickering eyes, or twitching muscles, all representing imbalances will tend to calm down. Heart pounding and arrhythmias will also subside. Insomnia will be much better under control. In other words, the root of these GI symptoms really points to an autonomic dysfunction. And in the case of adrenal fatigue, this is quite evident. The more advanced the adrenal fatigue is, the more vulnerable a person is to these type of symptoms. So fixing and helping the adrenal to sustain itself and heal itself remains the most fundamental and the most beneficial way to regulate the autonomic nervous system. The good news is that this can often be done, but it does require patience. It does require a practitioner who really knows what they're doing in order not to give the body symptomatic patches that mask the underlying problem. The body does have a tremendous ability to self-heal if only given a chance. The right way to do it can make a big difference, because the wrong way of doing it not only can make matters worse, but then it will give you a lot of fragility and allow the body to be in a state of disrepair over a time period. I hope you've enjoyed this video. For more information on this topic, head over to drlam.com, where I've written over 1,000 articles to help educate people. You can also call me at 626-571 1234 for more information on adrenal fatigue and how to navigate it. Finally, if you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.